30, a virtual pauper. His brothers, who perform as the group the Bee Gees, gathered at a special ceremony to honor Andy. They talked publicly about what went wrong with his life.
Gone in for so long. You and me been finding each other for so long.
Andy Gibb's success was a family tradition. He had the Gibb good looks and talent. His first three records went to number one on the charts. Very few artists have made it bigger, faster.
You get so much money so suddenly, so much fame, if you like, you know, you become very subjective to some things you normally wouldn't be subjective to. And if you survive all that, then it's great.
Today, his brothers remember Andy as a boy in a man's body who tried to please everyone and who couldn't deal with setbacks in his personal life or his career. As the Bee Gees, his brothers helped define the 70s, but Andy wanted to be his own man.
He had to achieve or do what they had done or more in order for him to feel comfortable with his own life, you know. So whatever we were, that is what he wanted.
He sold 20 million records and had a celebrated love affair with Victoria Principal. Tabloids claimed Andy's tailspin began when the highly publicized relationship ended, but his brother Barry says no way.
Andy's troubles were going on long before he met Victoria. So the idea that one can point a finger at her and say that's what's responsible for what happened to Andy, that's just rubbish.
He did quit drugs, but Robin Gibb says that wasn't enough.
He was great, he was clean, and things looked good to everybody else. But inside, there was a void, there was a vacuum. He just didn't, the things everybody told him that was going to be there once he gave all this stuff up wasn't there to fill the void. And to him, he had great expectations.
The last 2 years of Andy Gibb's life were spent in Miami, where he could be close to his brothers. Last week, his adopted home honored him with a street in his name, and his brothers remembered him.
He had the whole future, and whatever was wrong with him mentally or emotionally, he could have got better, and he could have, you know, done what he wanted to do. And I think that's the tragedy of this, that he died so young.